there because of their unbelief. Jesus could not do the works and the miracles that he wanted to do before the people because of their unbelief.
Yes, amen.
99.5 won't do. It's because of that 0.5% that we hinder our blessings. And there are certain things that keep us from receiving our blessings. Sometimes our situation will hinder us because of that unbelief.
Yes,
the little bit of doubt that we have deep down in the back of our mind, deep down in our soul, that you think no one can see, that is hindering us from blessings. The Bible says that we can move mountains if we had faith, as the mustard seed.
Yes, sir.
We could say to this mountain, move here and move there, and it can be done.
Yes, sir. All right.
We can ask our situations to get out of our life, and they will vanish away. Problems and heartaches and pains and sickness can leave us if we only had the faith of a mustard seed. But because of that little bit of doubt that's in us, we are hindering our own blessings that God wants us to have.
Wow.
Whether it be you want to be delivered from something that has you in turmoil, your mind, your flesh is telling us that I can't do it. But 99% of us is saying you can do it. But it's that little bit of doubt that is hindering us from receiving our deliverance. 99.5 won't do it. Have to be 100%.
Yes, sir.
Some of us are praying for different things. Husbands, we're praying for wives. We're praying for financial blessings. We're praying for deliverance from certain things. We're praying that our children will come back into the fold. We're praying for all sorts of things and wondering why our prayers are being hindered. It's all because of that 0.5% that is still lingering in our minds.
Yes,
sir. 99.5% won't do. It takes 100%. In order for the Lord to bless us.
Teach us.
John chapter 20, verses 24 through 29. But Thomas, one of the 12 called Didymus, was not with them when Jesus came. The other disciples therefore said unto him, we have seen the Lord. But he said unto them, except I shall see his hands, the print of the nails, and put my finger into the print of the nails, and thrust my hand into his side, I will not believe. And after 8 days again, his disciples were within him, and Thomas with them. Then came Jesus, the door being shut, and stood in the midst, and said, peace be unto you. Then said he to Thomas, reach hither my finger and behold my hands, and reach hither my hand and thrust it into my side, and be not faithless, but believing. And Thomas answered and said unto him, my Lord, my God. Jesus said unto him, Thomas, because thou hast seen me, thou hast believed. Blessed are they that have not seen and have yet believed.
Yes, sir.
Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Sometimes, if we don't see it, we don't believe it. And that's not faith. The disciples was with Jesus in today's lesson, Sunday school lesson. They seen him do miracles and great things. But when he came into his own saw these things done, but when he came into them, They believed him not that he was the Christ, because they didn't have any faith. Whatever they wanted to see in Christ, whatever, however they wanted to see him, hindered them from receiving more blessings and more miracles. And us today, we have to believe and trust 100% that God will give us everything we ask if we ask not in a mist, and ask in the light. But how can our faith be increased? How can we increase our faith that our prayers and our what we want will not be hindered? Romans 10 and 17 says, "So then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God."
Amen.
One thing we have to do to increase our faith is hear the word. We have to hear the word. And ask God to give us an understanding of the word. And ask the Holy Spirit to reveal us what the word is talking about, that we may receive and our faith may increase. Luke 17, 5 and 6. St. Luke 17, 5 and 6 says, "And the apostle said unto the Lord, increase our faith. And the Lord said, if ye had faith as a grain of a mustard seed, ye might say unto this sycamine tree, be thou plucked up by the root, and be thou planted in the sea, and it should obey you." 99.5 won't do. As I studied for this message, I found out that the mustard seed is not only small in size, and why Jesus talked so much about the mustard seed and the faith of a mustard seed. Not only is this mustard seed the smallest of herbs and grows to be the biggest of the trees, but it also is able to grow in different climates. It can grow in hot, dry climate as well as cold climate. And it comes in various types of